Hi Cancer, this is going to be a reading for, let me just move the camera, April 2020, happy super full moon you guys. I am in a very good energy today, just finished charging all my crystals and they're probably going back out once the moon moves to this side. Okay, so you've already got one, very nice. Recent past doesn't look as good, but your current energy looks very good here. Okay. Wow, okay, this is a very good reading. Because, like, the past looks a little bad, and then in the near future, we have the past coming back for another go-round here. Ooh, advice. Okay. Okay, let's get into it, you guys. So for Cancer, what I see here, your current energy is Eight of Wands, which can mean travel or, you know, fast moving. It's a very fast moving energy. So you could be getting a message, or, but I do get this is your energy. So you're moving very fast towards something or someone. But you're also staying very wise because you're in this High Priestess energy here. She's very smart. She's abundant. It's a water energy as well, so goes perfectly for you. You see how she has the moon at her feet. She's very intuitive, very feminine, and she knows all the secrets. She's very empathic as well. And Eight of Wands at the head of your energy, that's fast moving. So either you're moving really fast towards someone, or someone's moving really fast towards you. Someone could be traveling to see you, or you could be traveling to go see someone. Or this could simply be really fast, sudden communication with someone who's long distance. Very good energy though. This current energy is very good. It's kind of like, guys, remember, this is a general read, so take it as it resonates. It could, you know, fit for you as a love reading, or it could go for you as a finance or career reading. Maybe you're making really fast moves towards something in your career. It doesn't have to be love, but I'm getting a very love energy because I do see some heartbreak. And when do I not see heartbreak for Cancers? That's funny. But getting into it, your current energy is very good. It's like you're moving on, you're moving really fast, and you're still very smart, very in touch with your emotions and intuition. So you're not really making any stupid moves here. But whatever you're doing, you're kind of, you know, following your intuition. You're going with the gut feeling. Your recent past, I see Ten of Swords, which, you know, is heartbreak, pain, feeling defeated. This is in your recent past. But then also in your recent past, we have the Nine of Pentacles. And, you know, that's kind of funny because we have nine and then we have ten. So nine kind of means almost complete. And then ten means completely done. You know, whatever cycle it is, and it looks like something toxic has ended. Something that you probably put a lot of work or energy into, and it came to an end. It probably kept you down for a little while, but, you know, wounds heal, and there you are right now. You're in a very good energy. The High Priestess, I'm also getting, it could be that you were being kept in the dark by someone, whoever hurt you. Maybe they were keeping you in the dark and you found the clarity that you needed to move on from it. And you know, whatever this was in the past is completed. It's kind of done for you. You're done with that. You're not dealing with that again. But you also got the clarity that you needed to completely move on from whatever this was. And then, in the near future, coming towards you, I have Six of Cups and the Nine of Cups. So you see, guys, another nine here. So Six of Cups is, you know, pardon me. Six of Cups is someone returning from the past. It's a very past energy. So maybe this person who hurt you or someone from the past is coming towards you to offer you some information, to offer you some sort of, to give you some sort of message. But I don't see you, I do see you manifesting it. Maybe you're manifesting an apology from the person who hurt you, or, you're manifesting some sort of information, but I feel like you already have that information. This is what I'm getting. Okay, maybe this person was keeping you in the dark, wasn't clear about their intentions, or you know, kind of like being really closed off to you, and then all of a sudden they kind of just left you. They could have ghosted you, or they could have, you know, just broken up with you out of the blue, that you just didn't see it coming. Whatever this pain was, you were still putting in work and energy into the situation. All of a sudden they hurt you. You were down for a bit, but now you've gotten up, and you know, you did your own spying. Like, I'm seeing that you did your research about this person, you know, maybe ask around, or maybe finally heard what your friends were telling you about this person all along, and you know, you thought about it from a different perspective. Instead of putting this person on this pedestal, you started thinking of them as how they are, who they are, logically, and you know, kind of like looking back at the messages and kind of like trying to make sense of, hey, this person was telling me they were not good for me from the get-go. And then now you're making like good moves. You're moving on with your life. You're moving on fast. You could be traveling, or you know, far away from this person. Maybe you traveled right after this happened, you know. But then when they see you all pretty and all nice, they come back. And maybe you know what was going on with them, so you've been thinking about them coming forward to you and telling you or apologizing to you, and I see that they are coming back to you. Either they're trying to, you know, they're trying to fix things with you. They're coming back to fix things with you, or at least offer you some sort of information, some sort of closure, finally. They didn't, but I feel like that somehow you found it without them. Like, the emotions you had to process through, you did without them. The closure you needed, you moved on without that closure. Somehow, you managed it somehow, you know? And right when you're done with them, right when you can finally stop thinking about it, they come back. What? But this is Nine of Cups is a wish fulfillment card. That's why I keep saying that you might have been, you know, manifesting this apology or whatever this information or message is from them that's coming towards you. I definitely see something coming towards you really fast, and it's happening soon. But I don't see you taking it. Like, you are listening to it. You're not going to be mean or anything, but you'll be like, yeah, okay, I hear you, but you know what, I know my value, I don't need this, thank you for apologizing, but that's that, I don't want to deal with you. I also see you very single right now, whoever it is that's watching this video right now, or whoever this resonates with. I see you very single, because you see this lady is Nine of Pentacles, is a very single energy, and so is Nine of Cups. And then, so basically in April, someone's coming towards you from the past, okay? Someone that you have finally moved on from, someone who hurt you recently, or, you know, just a few months ago. It could be 8 weeks ago, because I'm seeing 8, 9, and 10. Could have been a few days ago, you know, 9, 10 days ago. But whoever hurt you, and they didn't give you enough, I'm seeing like someone feels abandoned, and you know, just defeated because someone put a lot of work, and now they're just like, there's nothing I can do to fix this. And there was nothing you could do, but somehow all you could really do was heal and move on, and you did. But right when you did, this person's coming to get you, and you're like, no, I know my value now, I love myself. This is a lot of self-work, a lot of healing, a lot of faith in your wish fulfillment. And this is also someone, you know, I'm getting a little self-indulgent type of behavior as well. You could be drinking and stuff, or you know, just going out with friends, just kind of celebrating life. It's like, at first it hurt that they weren't there, but now that you're happy without them, they come back. That's probably what I'll caption this video. We'll see. Advice for you is the Ace of Cups reversed and the King of Swords reversed. So King of Swords and Ace of Cups are both like lots of love, offer of love, emotions, you know. King of Swords is a clear-cut communication. So maybe after they give you this information, I'm seeing that you might block them. Your advice is that don't let this person get into your head. think from your head when it comes to replying to them and how to handle the situation. Don't give in to your emotions, is what I'm getting. Don't let your heart take over you, because Ace of Cups is in reverse. Really kind of control your emotions, kind of balance your emotions and your logic out before you reply to this person or say anything to them. But I feel like you're prepared for that, because I do see someone, you know, who's been manifesting this apology or whatever this is that's coming in from the past. I think you already know what you're going to say, and you're going to say, yeah, thank you for apologizing, but I'm good, I have moved on. But Ace of Cups is your advice that just be very aware of your emotions. You know, I'm not saying be emotionally closed off. I'm just saying voice your opinion, but do it in a way that it doesn't offend the other person, or, you know, doesn't give them a reason to turn it around on you. Or just like balance between logic and emotions is what you need to do. I'm going to clarify on this person a little. I just want to see, why is the Six of Cups here? Angels, please show me the cards I need to see. Universe, show me the cards I need to see. Two of Swords reversed. Okay. Yep, that's definitely someone from the past. It could be an air sign, Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. But it could really be anyone. It could be someone with that in their chart. Two of Swords in reverse is basically someone who was very indecisive, someone who, you know, kept you blindfolded. And Six of Cups, I am seeing that they are coming to offer you clarity, because they're no longer in this position. Now they're in reverse. So I definitely see someone who's coming to you, offer you clarity on some situation. Or, you know, coming to trying to explain themselves is what I'm hearing intuitively. But you're in a very good place right now, Cancer. You're very intuitive. You're very in touch with your feminine side. You're thinking of things properly. And, you know, High Priestess is someone who sits there quietly and just kind of watches the show before she does anything. So that's very good. But Eight of Wands, either they're coming in really fast towards you, or you are moving towards something new completely, entirely, very fast. It could be either or. It really depends on what you do. And your advice is to really balance your emotions and logics here. Possible outcome. Sorry, this was in reverse. Possible outcome between you and this person. What's the possible outcome? My Cancer. Oh. Three cards fell down. Six of Wands. You're coming out of this. Yeah, I don't think you're giving them your cup of love. And Death card. I'm getting you're just going to tell them that it's over. Whatever this was something that really changed you. They made a really deep impact on you. When they hurt you, they changed you. They really showed you. They really changed how you saw them. And now it's over for you from your side. You're saying it very, like, with full confidence. You know, you see her, she's like, then that's another six, guys, more past energy. But you see how confident she looks. She's saying, no, we're done. This love is gone. I'm not going to give you my cup of love anymore. Sorry. King of Cups is also Cancer in Scorpio. And then we have the High Priestess, that's also Cancer, but, and could be Scorpio as well, but. And there's more Scorpio here, huh? So you could be dealing with a water or air sign, or someone with a mix of both in their chart, you know. But yeah, I think you're saying it's over. And they just really made an impression on you. Like, they left a mark. And you didn't sit there with that mark for too long. It took you very long. It took you a lot of self-work, a lot of healing, a lot of transformation. That is what the Death card represents. And, oh my God, you guys, I just noticed something, but I'll get to it in a minute. You know, it takes a lot. It took a lot from you to really, like, keep your emotions behind and, like, logically think of how they treated you, how they were with you, and moving on from it took a lot of work. And you finally did it, and they're coming back, and you're like, no, you're not gonna mess with my peace. I'm done. I'm done with this. I'm not no longer offering you my love. I'm gonna keep it for someone who's worth it. What I just noticed is, you see how the King of Cups is wearing a blue suit and has a crown on his head, right? And under the Death card, there's a man on the floor, and his crown is off. He's also wearing a blue suit. Coincidence? No. Everything means something, you guys. So what I'm seeing is that you're turning it down. Maybe, you know, they left you for someone else, or they did something like that really hurt you, and now they're coming back and they're like, oh, I'm so sorry that I didn't treat you the way you really deserve. And you're just like, no, bye. Knocks them off their horse, takes their throne. Like, nah, I'm gonna sit on your throne. Thank you for keeping it warm for me. Goodbye. It's kind of like Ciao Bella, but it's a very good energy because you're looking good. You're the High Priestess, you're the Six of Wands, you're confident. It's like you've made a decision, and it took a lot of pain, a lot of work. You did a lot for this person, and you realized that it just wasn't worth it. They were not worth it. And you know that they have a lot of growing up to do before they can ever truly match your level of emotional intellect. That's a very weird thing for me to say, but that's what I'm getting. So good luck to you guys with this situation. We're gonna get into my advice for you and the affirmation card. I hope this reading didn't go too long. It's already 16 minutes. Come back. But wow, like, I just started and I was talking about myself, and it all just, like, the cards just started falling out, and your reading went, like, no gaps. Like, one message after another, it all makes sense. And, you know, kudos to you guys for, like, finally healing from that. Good job, Cancer. Good things are going to happen. Be open to receive miracles. That's my advice for you guys. That's my message for you. And we'll grab one more, okay? Just tell them how you feel or stop thinking about them. Maybe this is, I think this one's more for a cross watcher. But if there is someone that you feel like you've been thinking about a lot, you should probably tell them. Good things are going to happen. Be open to receive miracles. Remember that one, you guys. That's like a good one. And that one flipped on its own, you know? When the cards flip, we believe that it's the angels and our spirit guides trying to directly talk to you. Okay, sorry, I forgot to open the affirmation cards. But let's see, what does Cancer need to be mindful of? Courage. No one is fearless. No one. But even though I'm not fearless, I am courageous. When fear shows up, I don't run away from it. I use my courage to conquer it. My courage allows me to walk right up to the fear and kick it in the nuts, then quickly hide behind someone bigger until it goes away. Yeah, I think your fear is going to show up, aka the past person, and they're probably going to try sway you back into that old hot and cold or whatnot, whatever it was that hurt you so much. And I don't think you're having it. You know that they're not emotionally there yet. But that's all I have for you, Cancer. If you'd like a personal read, the information is in the description box below. And please like and subscribe if this resonates. Thank you.